All right, guys, I'm on vacation. I'm here in Noosa, Australia, one of the prettiest places you could ever visit in the world. And if you come to Australia, you come to Noosa, check out one of this guy's classes. I'm joined by the legendary Matty Fox. You guys can follow him. Instagram, Matty Fox?
Matty C. Fox.
Matty C. Fox, and then YouTube, Matt Fox Coach. So if you guys like bodyweight workouts, kettlebell stuff, more functional training, this is your man right here. So definitely check out more workouts. Today though, you guys ask me all the time, hey, how do you stay fit on the road? You know, when you're traveling, what do? A lot of it is bodyweight training. It's one of those things that if you have a beach, have a mat, you know, in a hotel room, you could always do bodyweight stuff. And Matt does a lot of that. So tell them a little bit about, you know, the style of training.
So basically, I've been into bodyweight training for about 3 years now. I don't get into a gym, I don't really lift weights, occasionally kettlebells, and I've just, all functional training that you can do anywhere. So Steve and I decided that, we're in beautiful Noosa, who wants to go to a gym? Get out here, this is our workout views, why not do a workout here?
I think it's a good place to do a workout. Got the sun, little vitamin D, little ocean behind us, so get a little workout, jump in there. Today's workout, 20 minutes. One of the things on vacation, you don't want to spend your whole day working out, so get after it, get your heart rate up, sweat, and then get out. So 20 minutes today, what we're going to be doing is a Tabata-style bodyweight workout. One of the things I would do a lot on The Biggest Loser is Tabata-style workouts. A lot of people, just their body weight is more than enough. So today, we're going to be doing that, picking essentially 4 supersets, and going back and forth, spending 20 seconds on, 10 seconds off. After we complete a whole Tabata round, you have a minute rest.
Yeah, and then moving on to the next superset. So each superset is gonna be 4 minutes in total. You'll end up doing 4 sets of each exercise, 8 rounds of that total.
It's gonna be sweaty. It's gonna be a sweaty mess. Let's do it.
Real sweaty.
All right, first 2 movements we're gonna be doing for this first round of Tabata, a burpee with a squat lunge and then flutter kick. So Matt's gonna demonstrate burpee, normal burpee, but instead of going right back down, boom, 2 lunges, 1 each leg, and then back down. Left leg, right leg, boom, back down. You get 20 seconds of that. Once that buzzer goes off, and we've hit our 10 seconds rest, we're in our flutter kick position. You can see his feet are, 6 inches off starting, and then he's just alternating the flutter kicks. Abs are tight, legs are tight, we're not bending at the knee, we're keeping everything very rigid. Keeping everything nice and tight, working those abs. 20 seconds of that, 10 seconds rest, and then we're back into our burpees. Let's get after it. All right, here we go. Ready to do it? 3, 2, 1. I don't want to work out. Definitely has gone through my mind, but just 20 minutes a day doing something. One round down, 4 to go.
When you're doing this, try and push your lower back into the ground too, and you'll feel that even more with your core engaging.
All another movement you can do instead of the flutter kicks is the leg over. So it's pretty much the same thing, just working a little bit different. Go here, back to here.
Last round. One more of each exercise.
Heart rate's up already. Next round of Tabata. All right, guys, we're on to round two. Same principle, 20 seconds on, 10 seconds rest, 20 seconds on of the second exercise. First exercise Matt's gonna demonstrate, it's a back extension. So everything we're doing today, while we're working one group, we're resting another group. So right now, obviously working the lower back, you're tight, just like we were on the flutter kicks, we're tight throughout, bringing up the shoulders and the legs at the same time. Now, if you want to make this a little bit more difficult, work a little bit more shoulders in there, depending on your range of mobility, keeping the arms out in front of you, just like Matt's doing here. Again, this is working your glutes. Your glutes need to fire. You're pretending, you know, you're squeezing at the glutes, using those lower back muscles, the spinal erectors, and you're raising up. 20 seconds of that, and then 10 seconds rest. And we're going into our second movement, which is going to be our shoulder tap. So this is going to be primarily working the abs here. We're also having to use a lot of stabilizing muscles here. You can see Matt's not twisting at the hip. Show him a bad rep here. Twisting at the hips there, letting the hips sink. Everything's going to be nice and straight on a perfect rep. Let's show him a good rep right there. Boom. Just his hands moving to touch his shoulder. Really good form there.
In line with the shoulders too.
Yeah, everything's in line. The shoulders, the elbows, the wrist, all in line there.
So if you make sure your palm of your hand is in line with your shoulders, you're gonna feel it in your chest and work your shoulders too. So it's gonna put obviously a lot of body weight on the shoulders and chest, and that'll bring that into play as well as the core.
Let's show them a modification now. Nice. Shoulder taps are a little bit more advanced. If you can't do the standard shoulder tap like we were doing, go to your knees and do them. Right there. This is a nice one to do again. If you can't do the prescribed exercise, we're gonna make it a little bit easier for you. And again, the muscles we're working here, pretty much all push muscles, anterior delt, tricep, chest, core. What we were working before with the back extensions, lower back, glutes, and the posterior delts, and the traps in there. So again, offsetting so we don't fatigue too fast, too early. So let's get into it. All right, round two, here we go. Loving that glute squeeze. Posterior chain working here. If you can't get to the gym and do squats, this would be another exercise that really helps that posterior chain. Round's all about those little muscles. Mm-hmm. all about core here. Last round.
One more ovation.
One more.
Final 20 seconds, then we got a minute break.
Woo! Shoulders, abs, lower back, glutes.
Back for round three. What we're going to do on this one, we got kick sits. This is the first 20 seconds, and that's going to be paired with frog squats. Steve's going to demonstrate kick sits to begin with. His palms are going to stick flat to the ground, and he's going to shoot through his leg. Hips going to sit down for a brief second, come back in that bear position, and shoot through to the other side. So when he speeds it up, it's going to look like that. You'll notice that when he's in this starting position, his knees are pretty close to his elbows in that bear crawl position, and he's pivoting from the hips. Now, if you want to do an abbreviated version of this, he's going to get into mountain climbers, still palms on the ground, like when we did the shoulder taps, and he's going to drive his knees forward to between his hands. So that's the first 20 seconds, either kick sits or mountain climbers, you choose. Next 20 seconds, we're going to do things called frog squats. His elbows are going to stick tight to the inside of his knees the whole time. They're not gonna leave, so tension's always there, and he's gonna stand up, shooting the hands through as far as they can go. You'll see that he's not gonna be able to fully stand up because of this tension, and that is gonna bring the hamstrings into play, as well as cook the quads.
Woo!
So it's just a double burn here for the lower body.
This one is just straight evil, because we're not actually locking anything out. There's constant tensions on your legs. A lot of lactic acid in this one. Biggest thing here too, I'm using my elbows, and I'm actually pushing out my knees. You know, if you guys are a person that squats and has those knees cave in, this is a great reminder. Elbows inside of the knees, boom, right here.
You'll also see his heels don't leave the ground too. Toes can come off, but heels are stuck to the ground. That's a proper squat form as well.
Just showing the demonstration, mate. My quads and glutes are on fire.
Woo! Let's do it.
Yeah, this round's gonna suck. Here we go. 3, 2, stand up. All this adductors.
Oh,
check it out. Well, that was in a long time.
Bodyweight stuff here.
Absolutely reckless.
Get going.
Reckless.
Last one of kick six.
Alright, we've got the final 4 minutes of this bodyweight Tabata. Next pair, we've got prone walkouts, which is really going to hit your hamstrings, and that is paired with high knees, a little bit of abs, a ton of cardio. Steve's going to demonstrate the prone walkouts. So, hips are up in the glute bridge. Then he's going to slowly walk out onto his heels as far as he can go without dropping the hips, and walk back in, keeping the hips up. So you're walking in, you're walking out. You'll feel that hell of a lot in the hamstrings, so your hips don't drop. Then we're gonna jump up on our feet. I know you're really looking forward to this one. High knees, so palms are out, hitting our knees to our palms. 20 seconds of that, we're alternating between the pair. Final 4 minutes.
Modification on the high knees, just be a jumping jack. So if you're really finding you can't get your knees up there, jumping jack will work.
Let's do it.
Last round, best round. This is our final Tabata, 4 minutes. Give your all. Yeah. Blood's in my legs.
10 seconds.
Woo! Done and done. If you guys like this workout, make sure you head over to Matt's channel, Bodyweight King. I'm feeling a couple of those stoning woods coming up, so I'm gonna go jump in the ocean. Thank you guys for watching. Make sure thumbs it up for Maddie. Go check out his channel.